Hi everyone, and welcome to this review note. In this clip, we're going to be looking at how do we set a particular switch to be a root bridge in a spanning tree network. I've got my topology set up. I've got three edge switches. I have a distribution switch. And normally what we want to do is configure a distribution switch to be our root bridge, unless we actually have a core layer as well, in which case that would be the root. But we want to have our traffic flow through the distribution. We don't want to have links disabled, like we can see this one over here, and then end up forcing traffic to go through some edge switch someplace and overwhelm that switch with traffic when that's not what we really have intended. I'm going to select my distribution, which I'm going to make my root bridge. All I'm going to do is modify the priority from spanning tree to make that lower than everything else. We can see from a previous display showing spanning tree that the root bridge has a priority of 32.769. We also have this bridge with a priority of 32.769, which is the default in the Cisco world. I'm going to go into global config, and I'm going to use the spanning tree command. Next thing we have to specify in our particular case is a VLAN, because we set the root bridge on a VLAN by VLAN basis. So I'll do VLAN, and then we've got the opportunity to specify a single VLAN, or you can see by the message we can also do a range. So if this switch is going to be the root bridge for all VLANs, we could just put the entire range of VLANs that we have. We're going to do VLAN 1 since that's the only one that we have. And then once we've done that, the options are we can either set the priority or we can actually specify root. Now, if we've only got one root bridge, then all we have to do is specify a root, and when the election takes place, this one will become the root. But let's say that I've got redundant distribution switches. What I would do in that case is I would set the priorities, and the one that I want primarily to be my root bridge, I'll set the priority a little bit lower than the one that's going to be the backup. In any case, I'm going to set the priority, and I'm going to set this to midway between the default and one. And that's all I have to do. At this point in time, spanning tree is going to reconverge. If I show spanning tree, I can see now that the address for the root bridge is the same as my MAC address on the switch, which means this is now going to be the root bridge. And just to verify, I can come down to one of these other systems. We can see previously on desktop 2, here's the MAC address of the bridge. Here is the MAC address of the original root bridge. If I rerun this command, we can see that the MAC address on the root bridge is now different, and we can also see the priority is lower. So that matches up into my distribution switch. So all there is to configuring the root bridge on the network is the end of the video. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.